instant multicam syncing in Final Cut Pro. Syncing multicam with auto-synchronization can be a long drawn-out process when you're editing long events with many short B-roll clips. I'll show you an actual workflow to almost instantly sync multiple B-roll clips to a 1.5 hour main camera clip in just a few seconds. The following workflow was a revelation to me when I accidentally discovered it, and it could have saved me hundreds of hours if I'd known about it earlier. At the end of this video, I'll show you a second revelation to quickly match clips that are close to being in sync. This is the scenario I'm working with. The event is 1 hour 40 minutes long. It's broken into 2 main cam clips, 4 audio clips, and 54 B-roll clips. Yes, 54 B-roll clips. And to make this even more amazing, some of the B-roll clips were only 2 to 3 seconds long. Just imagine how to get those in sync with the audio in a near 2-hour event. I've rarely been able to match up 2-hour clips. That's if ever. As I normally do, I've labelled the main camera, the B-roll, and the audio clips in the inspector. Next, select all the 54 B-roll clips and multicam them together. Right-click, select New Multicam and name it B-roll Assembly. Turn off Sync, Audio Synchronization. Angle Assembly, Camera Name. Angle Clip Ordering, Automatic. And Angle Synchronization, Automatic. Press the OK button, and it's as quick as that. And here's the multicam clip with all of those 54 B-roll clips in a consecutive time sequence. The next step is to multicam all the main camera clips together with the separate audio clips. Name this multicam Main Camera Assembly. And don't forget to turn on the sync audio synchronization. Use the same camera angles as in the first multicam. Angled Assembly, Camera Name. Angle Clip Ordering, Automatic. And Angle Synchronization, Automatic. Once the multicam is completed, check that the audio clips are in sync with the main camera clips. Have the playhead over 2 clips and make sure the audio button is blue at each angle. Now add a new angle to the main camera assembly and make that angle the monitoring angle. Go to the B-roll assembly and select all the clips, Command A. Copy those, Command C, and return to the main camera assembly. And because the new empty angle in the main camera assembly was made the monitoring angle, when you paste the clips with the playhead at the beginning of the project, the clips will paste into that new angle. Select all the clips of the monitoring angle and make a compound clip. To sync the compound clip, reduce the size of the main camera clips and also reduce the size of the B-roll to be just enough to cover what you expect to be the same in the main camera angle. Be very careful not to move the clips in any way, just shorten them. Change the monitoring angle to the main camera. Then using sync synchronization to monitoring angle, sync the shortened B-roll angle with the shortened main camera angle. And you'll see the B-roll clip move a little. Check that they're in sync. Carefully return all the clips to their original length without moving their location in any way at the angles. And if you need to adjust the sync of individual clips in the compound clip, you'll need to split the clips at the blank spots. Compound clips can't be broken apart in a multicam sequence. And don't ask me why, it just seems illogical, but that's the case and we have to accept it. So once that clip's separated from the multicam, you can check the sync of the individual clip with the sync synchronization to monitoring angle command. And as an explanation, you'll have noticed that to sync the multicam of the B-roll with the main camera angle, I shortened the clips. The reason is that the computer needs to do a lot of work trying to match up all of the audio from the B-roll with that hour and a half of audio from the main camera angle. So if you give it just a shortened clip to try and sync, it'll have less to check, and subsequently, it'll be able to match the available audio much quicker. I do, and I suggest that you, always shorten clips in long multicam sequences. And one other tip. For many years, I've found that trying to match too many clips at a time just freezes up the multicam process. So, I've always matched a few angles at a time and then added the other camera angles to that multicam assembly and used the sync selection to monitoring angle to match them up. I hope you get as much value out of this video as I've had by discovering this revelation. Well, a revelation to me at least. Thanks for watching.